Welcome to this course on Recurrent Neural Network. So this is the first lecture on the series on Recurrent Neural Networks, and here we will see the introduction and the motivation behind studying RNNs. In short, we call it RNN for Recurrent Neural Networks. So let's see how is it different from traditional neural networks. So in traditional neural network, we have some inputs and we have corresponding outputs, and these are independent of themselves. That is, first input output pair is independent of next input output pair. These are separate and independent data, whereas in RNN we feed one input x1 and we get one output y1 from this state and one some activation a1. And in the next time step, this is fed to the next step, and again it gives y2, and this is further fed to the next state, and so on. So here the previous output is fed to the next output, so it has a memory, and you can represent it as this. So this is the current output, it depends on the past output and the current state. So this is how it's different from traditional neural networks. Now let's see some motivating examples. Where is it used? So it is very useful when we have some sequential data. So there is some notion of sequence among the data. Like when we are speaking one sentence, so the different words in a sentence are related. Like when we say Ben Cutting is a great player. So there is a flow of, there is a grammar associated with this sentence. Each words are not independent of themselves. So this each is dependent on what came before it. So we were naming some player, so it's each. If we had multiple things, it could have been are or were. So this word depends on previous words, or sometimes it may also depend on some later words. And on the other hand, you could have said Ben is cutting a birthday cake. So here cutting is a verb, an action he is performing, Ben, whereas here cutting is the surname, Ben Cutting. So here the words are related to each other and they are not independent of each other. So when we have a concept of sequential data, then this RNN is very useful. For example, let's see some examples like machine translation. So we are given one sentence in English, I am learning machine learning, and we are asked to translate it to Hindi. So it's Hindi is main machine learning seekh raha hoon. Now let's see some more example. Name entity recognition. So here we are given a sentence and we are asked to find the words which correspond to some name. So here Ram, Sam and John, these are the names of some person. So the task of this RNN is to predict these words. So we can denote it as 10100101. So one means this word corresponds to a named entity. So similarly, we can have sentiment classification, like we are given some review, some feedback by one of the viewers of the movie. The viewer says that the movie was pathetic and boring. So from this, we can predict how much star the audience, the viewer would have given. So it predicts that the movie needs to be given one star. And then we can use it in word prediction. So you write, you have seen this application in Gmail, like you are typing something and it tries to predict the future words, or in your mobile smartphone, you are typing some message and it automatically suggests future words based on what you have typed in past. So for this case, wish you a happy, so it can predict birthday or maybe some other words also. So in word prediction also it can be used. So in each of these cases you see there is some sequence associated with different data, and you can have a one-to-one relationship. So here the input had 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 words, and here output had 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 words. So it's not necessary that there will be exactly one-to-one mapping, but here we have one-to-one mapping because we have to tell whether a word belongs to a named entity or not. So 2, 4, 6, 8. So here there is a one-to-one relationship. Here also there is many-to-one relationship, and here we have similar to one-to-one relationship. So there can be one-to-one or many-to-one or one-to-many relationship. Like you are asked to generate some music and you just give the genre of the music and it will generate a long music. So here it's one-to-many or zero-to-many. So this was the first lecture. In the further lecture we will see learn more about recurrent neural networks. Thank you.